let any man, don't let any woman to stop your destiny. Is your destiny, is your calling, you know? She just put a question mark. Is the guy controlling? Is the guy trying to control her? Or the guy is just trying to manipulate her? Or the guy is just trying to bring out educational purpose from her, you know? Hello, elegant, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Is your favorite baby girl, Miss Siwa? And if you are new to my channel, my name is Nausi, and you can call me Miss Siwa in the comment section down below. We talk about almost everything on this our YouTube channel, so please consider to subscribe.
This is her name. Please subscribe. Siwa and Beauty on. That's it. Please, you all.
So in today's video, we are going to talk about a young lady that bring out some. She bring out this topic, and please, as you listen to this topic, try and leave your own thought in the comment section down below. And the topic goes like this, and said, "This guy I am dating of 6 months wants me to move in with him in the future, yet he is putting condition one that my dog, which he knew is very important to me, cannot move in with us. Two, that he does not want to get marriage by paper. Is controlling," just put a question mark, "is the guy controlling? Is the guy trying to control her? Or the guy is just trying to manipulate her?" You know, so she needs our own thought. And right now, let me go ahead and read out some thought before I will tap my own speech into this comment. So if you don't understand what this our lady said, is that she met a guy. They have been together as boyfriend and girlfriend 6 months now, and the guy said the lady, the young, this our sister, should move in with her, like they should be staying in the same house, you know, as boyfriend and girlfriend. But the guy have two conditions that he gave this our sister, that one, our sister should not take dog along with her, because this our sister has a dog, and this dog is very, very important to this our sister, you know. So the guy said, "No, you are not coming with your dog, and second, I will not marry by paper, you know." So they will marry, and then they will marry like secret marriage, no signing of paper and so on and so forth. So he's not going to do such marriage like that, you know. So those kind of secret marriage, that is the kind of marriage our brother wants. Not the kind of marriage that where they will say, go to office that in the street number 2, go to office street number 5, go and sign some paper, bring the paper to this office, bring the paper to the other place. Our brother said he don't need that. What he need is that, let's just do it secretly. And then we both know that we are not married, you know. So our sister is asking right now, is this normal? Is the guy trying to control her? Or she needs some advice from us. And then right now, let me just go ahead and read that some thought before I would dive my own topic into the matter. "Please, please, please say no, you know. If he cares about you, he will learn to like the dog." That is the dog. That is the first thing. "Not make you separate from your best friend to be your dog. Do not like him either, you know. And yes, he is controlling." The third is controlling. "Not wanted to make your union legal when if he is that important to you. Means the back door is always open for him. He will accuse you of loving a dog more than him. Do not fear for that. It is not a competition and a stupid composition. You know, walk away. First, your dog is your family. What is his reason for not wanting the dog? Unless he is severely allergic, then he does not really have a good enough reason to dismiss this. Then boyfriend, now husband, was not a fan of cats, yet home my 2 cats for a year. We are a long distance uni study, so then could not live with me. So I got to see them and him every weekend. He grow to love them and then become our cat. A decent guy would accommodate the dog, knowing what the dog meant to you. Secondly, unless you do not want to get married, either that it is best to cut your loser and leave now. Please do not move in with him and give up your dog in the process, thinking he will change his mind. He is communicating his intention as clearly as possible to you. It might sound harsh, but I will leave the relationship at this stage. It is only been six months. Imagine wasting 6 years if you move in, but long to settle down, get married, and possible have kids in the future. It is set his deal breaker. It is time to set your good luck. To him, no cookies until he put a ring on it. And if he is not going to put a ring on it, then get the FK out the way so you can find someone that wants to put a ring on it. But he has a ring in 2 weeks. Wash low. He does not like your dog. Forget that part and run away. OMG. Like, a lot of people is saying that the lady should not agree with this young man that said, I don't love your dog. And secondly, I don't want to marry you. You just met him 6 months and he has all these rule and regulation. Like, trust me, if you have been like 1 year, I think his own rule and regulation will just fill out all the whole apartment, you know, because just 6 months now. Let's just say you have been together for 6 years. I think you cannot even accommodate his rule and regulation. So my sister, take a walk and leave that relationship. That guy doesn't worth your time. And so all this time you have been wasting, asking questions here and there. You don't need to ask questions. You should be the one to sit down and ask yourself, gosh, I just met this guy 6 months ago and this guy is asking me to move in with him. And right now, he knew that I have this dog before we met. And this guy is asking me to just get rid of my dog and move in with him. And secondly, he's not going to get married with me. As in, like my sister, let me ask you, have you ever sit down, say that you will never married? If you have decided not to marry and you have decided to live somebody's life, not the life you wish for yourself, then you can be in this relationship. But if you have been dreaming to live the kind of life you wish to live, like people are traveling and you want to be like them, you want to be a traveler and you have that money. Example, people are traveling and you want to be a traveler. You have that money to travel around the world and you not mean this guy. The guy is telling you that, no, babe, let's just sit down at home, see donor, let's always order online for them to bring food stuff to us at home so that we can be enjoying at home. And that is not the life you ever wish to live. Live happily. You will never live happily. You will never have peace. You will be thinking, because that is your dream. You're not living the good dream you want to live. Like, you are living somebody's dream. But if that makes sense, you are living somebody's dream, not your own dream, you know? So please, if you want to become a pilot, if you want to become a driver, like you want to drive around the world, if you want to be a traveler, if you want to be a YouTuber, and if you want to be a marketer, do it. Just do it. Don't let any man, don't let any woman to stop your destiny. It's your destiny. It's your calling, you know. So it is what you are good at. There are a lot of people that have been a full-time YouTuber. These kind of people, they are graduate, like they read a lot of course. But at the end, they become a YouTuber. That is because it is their dream. You know, it's their dream. You can't, because of my dad spent a lot of money on me to study. And right now, I'm not doing a YouTuber. Sitting down, just talking. Whenever I'm going to supermarket, filming. Does that make sense? Mean that they train with a lot of billions of euro. Or mean that they train with a billions of naras. I'm not a YouTuber. Sitting down, talking rubbish. Talking to people around the world. Am I supposed to be doing that? I'm supposed to be working in one kind of office? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. As far as you are making money out of whatever you are doing, perfect. You are perfect. So my sister, my advice to you is that, girl, just leave this relationship. This guy doesn't want you, and you, he doesn't want that guy. And that guy is not your type. No, 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 it's not your type. Under 6 months, you met this guy, and he has a lot, like a lot to tell you. Dude, yes, no, I don't get it. In order, the guy is trying to fix you in the position you never wish to be. If this guy finally even marry you, in that kind of marriage, you will be a slave in that kind of marriage, because this is a guy that have a lot of rule and regulation. He don't want your dog, and he knew that you love this dog, like you cherish the dog. The dog is really important to you. That is to say, the guy never even need your opinion. The guy doesn't want you. As you are crying or you are happy, it doesn't matter to him. He just wants you to fulfill all his own urge, but you don't want to fulfill yours. That is the kind of a man you want to be with in the rest of your life. And this is the guy you want to settle with in the rest of your life. I don't think so. I don't think so. Sis, please walk away. Doesn't deserve you. So that's just what I have to say on this very topic. And you that is watching me right now, if you have any advice, opinion, review, so give this our lovely sister that the guy is just conditionally giving condition, rule and regulation. Please leave your own thought in the comment section down below. Turn up your post notification. Share this video for your friend and family. And I will see you elegant in my next video. Have a blessed and wonderful day. Do make sure to stay blessed and bye-bye.
This is your name. Please subscribe.